What did I say to piss you off this time?
Who is the Negro in your neighborhood? In your neighborhood? In your neighborhood? I say, who is the Negro in your neighborhood when you're running from his ass each day?
Black people don't hope, we wish.
Something that crazy could only come from you.
Right now you live in belief. You want to believe things. Belief is ignorance. Right knowledge is to know. Understand that? Belief is ignorance because belief is the acceptance of things that you do not know. And every one of your prayers end with Amen.
Let me hear you say amen. Oh, let me hear you say amen.
Amen, which is the ancient Egyptian god, Amun, and the rock. The rock was the sun in us as the original people of the sun. And we roamed the earth millions of years, 17 million, 20, 50,000 years ago, back before Adam was created 49,000 years ago. Now, we don't know good people from bad. We don't know good food from bad. We don't know good music from bad. We don't know anything, and we were the ones who knew everything. And so they put us under a spell. What kind of spell? The spell of ghost worship. You understand? Ghost worship. And they said gospel. Ghost spell. All you know is what they told you, and you have belief in what they told you. When we were in our right state of Elohim, we didn't have beliefs. We knew, because we were the gods that everybody worshiped. They made us hate the rising of the sun. By John, make sure you don't make fudge while the sun is rising. That's because we were sun people. People trying to get away from the sun made us start hating the sun. How'd they make you hate your hair? No, by telling you to big cock. The moment we start cocking our hair and cussing our hair and putting our feet on the grass again, things are going to start opening. We lost our eye and our life is dim.
Yeah, baby, that's right. We are back once at it again, and that's right, from New York to Jamaica to Cali to Japan, Doma Doma live from Ground Zero. That's right, the fastest 30 minutes on the air. Your radio show shows bust that ass, 83.7 FMX in the extent, so you never saw me coming when you never saw where it's at, dumbass. Yo, Black Lenny Bruce on the loose, who's better than a balding mini-me, two-pump chump of a boyfriend, and yes, I'll run rings around that flat ass like Saturn, so test me, bitch. And if I say anything to offend you, then you know I'm doing my motherfucking job, because you have the option of turning me off when I keep turning you on again and again and again, like a bad Big Bird costume. Cash ass, let's ride, bitches. You know how we start this with L.A. racist entitlement. And that's right, coming to the forefront of the question of the day. Is the silver bullet from the gun as slick as the favorite tongue of deceit available from the blue curtain of the quote-unquote good old boys club measure of integrity? Or how dirty is the hand on your nuts that asks you to clack them in when they're the ones slacking on fucking your job up? Okay, you be the judge. This happens to be the best sucker punch in the world in work relations, especially if one is trusted to be the ones you do trust to, under the directives of the job or position, help your fellow employee at a performance-based job. Incidentally, JOB is the acronym for the just over broke people like myself. So, does it matter of the fraternity underneath the badge when one lies for another just to advance within the crabs in the barrel syndrome we call capitalism? Check it. It all started with one officer doing a favor for a couple of colleagues. Cecilio Flores, an LAPD motorcycle officer, already had two arrests the night of September 3rd, 2010, when he saw a woman run stop signs on Avenue 52, north of Ground Zero, LA, just after midnight the next morning. He said the bitch was drunk. When Flores testified, he knew officers Craig Allen and Phil Walters, the other motorcycle officers working the same drunk driving enforcement detail, didn't have any arrests yet. He called them in and so forth and said, hey, you know, you guys can, you know, have the arrest on your stats. A move, Flores said, officers refer to as a gimme. Just give me the light and spot the Joe, you know. Nobody likes to come in last on stats, so this becomes a competitive nature to hem your ass, meaning you, the dumbass public at large, like it's a fucking game show. No wonder human hunting is slowly becoming a blood sport and not some tall tale from Hollywood hack writers. But lo and behold, when the ink hits the paper, the shit, and I mean shit, goes to court. Both Craig Allen and Phil Walters hadn't seen a woman blown through two stop signs, and they hadn't pulled her over. Another officer had done that, then called Allen and Walters to the scene to give her a sobriety test. Yet, Allen wrote in his arrest report, and both men testified in separate hearings, they had personally witnessed Dana Tarkatu run the stop signs. Okay, you know where I'm going with this, right? What the fuck? Okay, if I have to spell out perjury, then it starts with a P, which I hope you're not involved with the golden shower at the time. Because of the inconsistent testimony, the city attorney dropped the drunk driving charge against Tarkatu. After a preliminary hearing Wednesday, a judge ordered Walters, 57, and Allen, 39, to stand jury on perjury and false report charges. Allen had been fired from the LAPD since then, and Walters is now suspended. Now, keep in mind that the motherfucking court system is slower than a porno made by blind people for the deaf, and the poor constables in questions have to rely on each other, as they are touted to do under job description, until it becomes, quote-unquote, every man with a career for himself, i.e. the crab in the barrel syndrome again. Competitive nature my ass, the LAPD spills more blood on its own as quick as it will spill it on the streets against the poor, as a prerequisite to the job of kill or be hung out to dry by your own. Regardless if there are two in a squad car, there's always a weak link, an Achilles heel, so to speak, that can be a public loophole to exploit. Keep in mind that the majority of these assholes don't like paperwork, especially the ridiculous kind that doesn't bring in the glory of a fresh accidental in the line of duty and to be exonerated killing of a nigga going to the liquor store to get a blunt and some dick hardening pills for the hoe he's a baby daddy to. Only to be profiled, arrested, or killed because there are stats, quote unquote, to report on who gets the gimme on Jimmy Lobo. That's called promotional justice under a lying blue tongue. Cop killer, better you than me, bitches. That's right. I'll be black after this.
That's the sound of the police. That's the sound of the beast. That's the sound of the police. That's the sound of the beast.
There is no justification. None at all.
Kids, my big kids in the car by themselves until my mom arrived on the scene. They didn't give me my Miranda rights. 11 o'clock payment, 11 o'clock on my phone the next day. Then some man coming in with a piece of paper talking about I'm under arrest. But I've been there since 4 o'clock p.m. You just now arrested me. 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock the next morning. So why am I in here if I wasn't arrested? My brother got shot, like they said, in the back of the head, came through out his temple, in the back of the leg, and in the back. Why did you do that? He said you had a gun. And I've been out there for 10 hours, and nobody find no gun, and nobody find the item that they say in the news that he was trying to take. Where the victim at? You just seen, it wasn't even a phone call, said he robbed somebody. You just happened to be going that way and seen an African-American running and start to take the suit. You didn't know what was going on until after he was already dead. So why did you kill him? That's what I want to know.
Watch out! We run through y'all!
There is no justification, none at all, for responding with violence.
If I was here just now and said, oh, I feel threatened, I'm licensed to carry a gun, I murdered someone here because I felt threatened, there was no gun found with neither one of them, and the only thing that this family has gotten back was because they're the police department and they felt threatened for their lives, and they were licensed to carry a gun. That's injustice. I feel like there needs to be a thorough investigation. The police, whoever is involved, need to be accountable. Each one of us in here has to be accountable for our actions. Why not them? You know, if this family is hurting, imagine if I took someone life and you imagine your parents not being able to sleep, your kids turning to drugs, your wife losing her mind. It has an effect on everyone. And I feel like there's no effect for them. This family has gone through a lot and no one seems to even care about the pain. We're part of society, so what we feel is going to reflect on everyone here. Somebody help bandage us. We're hurting. We're crying. We're protesting, speaking out. Anybody, we're crying for help. Somebody please do something. This is not right.
There is no justification, none at all, for responding with violence.
You just walk up and break my bed without saying a word. A boo. Boo on you, sir.
That's the sound of the police.
Oh, yes, Mosquito's Facebook report, fat bitch itty dick. Ah, the stuff I found on my Facebook, crazy, shocking, but true. This same thing from Assbuster Amnesty International. It's a pick quote from 13-year-old Malala Yousafzai, okay? She said, I don't mind if I have to sit on the floor in school. All I want is education. I'm not afraid of no one. Get it, Wankster? Her lethal weapon of choice is her mind. This one sent in by Assbuster and good goofball, fellow goofball, Kayla Levin Jaden Johnson. It says, I think putting it's complicated as my relationship status is nicer than he's a complete asshole. Honey, we think the same of that sugar and spice Monica too. Now go pick them toes. And finally from Assbuster and favorite nutcase Noel Mooney, girl, you need help, but I love you just the same. A pick post that is all about freedom, if you know it. It says, warning, I support free speech, not political correctness. I mean, damn, if you can't get in the program, stop fucking up the future, will you? Damn. That's right, Black Aborca, celebrating 50 years of militancy against fascism. The mark of the Black Panther Party has left an indelible mark on American society. Thus far, no media outlet has made mention of it because some of the aging members are still wanted by the FBI, and those who are now in their 60s, 70s, 80s, and 90s are still in federal prison, dead, or have moved to Canada or Africa living in exile. My brother Muhammad Martinez is the only one left in LA who still gets a regular visit from the FBI chapter out here. They even brought him his dossier to show that they're still tracking him. He's in his 60s now. So when everyone left, he stayed to continue to fight for better race relations, the improvement of in humanity as a whole, and the freeing of Palestine from a Zionist state. Hey, don't blame me. I'm just celebrating the 20-year anniversary of Tacos and Grits radio show, the only radio show that brought KPFK 90.7 out of obscurity, and those liberal racist bastards there know it. That's why they don't have any black and brown programming now. And I got the news article to prove it, bitches. Oh yeah, they hot on the block, dirty condoms. I love it when it rains in LA. Motherfuckers can't drop a shit when it sprinkles over 30 seconds or can't drive for shit to begin with. That's why no bitch is driving my car ever. Okay, it's cash your ass, so hit it, roll it up. Speaking of such, I watched my favorite butterball hoe take a nasty spill running after a cheated blowjob fee. I mean, it's kind of funny though. I mean, to watch her roll down the hill off James Wood Avenue. In the meek hours between Indigo and Dawn, I see a lot when I leave my man cave. I mean, shit. I mean, it would explain the 15% increase in the homeless around here, but who's got the time to tally that shit when the city doesn't fucking care about its homeless hoes any damn way?
We know that immigrants in this country work hard. And for that reason, we have today union leaders from the laborers, construction, from hotel workers, from public sector workers, from janitors. Because immigrants are the ones who build this country day in and day out.
I just thought it's better because you're too many now. You've been too many Negroes and Hispanics. I'll tell you one thing, if you Negroes and Hispanics keep coming over, we're going back in the mix, Lava.
Are you still moved by what you see?
They're deporting people like crazy, you know, right now. And these are the people who need to function our society. And without them, you know, without immigrants, we're all immigrants, you know.
Where is that people from?
From Mexico. My parents are from Mexico. And I'm first generation. And
I will work for food. Can't you see my sign?
Are you still moved by what you see? Are you still moved by what you see?
You know, it was like, at least.
Yes, you know what time it is. It is now time for cultural nepotism. Gotta love stupidity. Once more, the federal government's attempt on tracking homegrown terrorists is going to be the staple of Cold War ethics allowable. That means the continuous war on minorities becomes the dirty war for control. Example, not one fucking dime in the $700,000 of surveillance equipment was allocated to any affluent neighborhood, which makes it a high priority target for crime. Okay? Because nobody is really looking at them. I mean, it's bait, dumbasses, and they're too busy looking at us with all that equipment to get it. Okay? You know, come on. The spick and nigger brigades of idiots who have nothing better else to do but to try everything in the name of a busted hustle. You fucking kidding me? You gotta be kidding me, right? I mean, ask the dumbasses that tried to rob a damn shoe store at 8 a.m. in the morning in South Central. Fucking brilliant. And I'm not letting that one go for shit. Oh, and expect those surveillance cameras, you know, the $700,000 worth to be installed by December. Fuck. Y'all motherfuckers wanted your 15 minutes of fame. There it is. But let me square this up for you, okay? A governmental bounty on MS-13, you know, one of the largest gangs, which operates in at least 42 states,
with ties to El Salvador, Mexico, Guatemala, and Honduras, was added to the Obama administration's list of significant transitional criminal organizations, a label that will subject its members to a host of economic sanctions, a pre-war move, if I do say so my motherfucking self. It's not only tracks of the dough going to the cartels, but reaps the biggest bulk of the money. So you mean since 1972, when the war on drugs was waged before the CIA imposed a crack epidemic against niggas, the government has been raking in seized drug money by the trillions, and this country is still fucking broke? Counties are streamlined into penny pinch deals and are left with budgets for crime they have to impose on the poor by taxing the shit out of them just to fight an amoebic crime wave that, as long as there are desperate idiots out there, the brainstem will stay connected to their ass. There you go, people. That's what I'm talking about. Straight up. Fucking just keep paying the piper, bitches. You'll get a hit out of it eventually.
Today's more Republicans are running from Romney. The Romney campaign is in full panic mode, trying to save the sinking ship. But he has a new strategy. For 3 days since the secret tape was revealed, Mr. Romney's been on damage control. He's trying to put his spin on the secret tape. He's trying to see what he can say after getting caught saying 47% of Americans are freeloading off the government. He could have responded in any number of ways to the tape. What did he do? He did this.
First of all, this is a campaign about the 100%. So my campaign is about the 100% of America, and I'm concerned about them. I'm concerned about the fact that over the past 4 years, life has become harder for Americans. More people have fallen into poverty. This is a campaign about helping people who need help, and right now, the people who are poor in this country need help getting out of poverty. The people in the middle class need help. I care about the 100%. People in America are going to have a better future if they elect me the next president.
Does he think we're stupid? I mean, honestly, does he think the American people are stupid? Mr. 1% and now Mr. 47% now wants us to believe he's Mr. 100%? 3 days ago, we heard him call 47% of the country victims who mooch off the government. This is what he said about them. My job is not to worry about those people. Yet, magically, all of a sudden, he's concerned about all Americans. Give me a break. Governor Romney's new strategy, his play for the middle class, his play for all Americans, just gave President Obama the political equivalent of a sledgehammer to go on the attack today.
People want a hand up, not a handout. The people who are not paying income taxes are either paying a lot of taxes because they're working every day, but they just don't make enough money overall to pay income tax. Or alternatively, they're senior citizens, or they're students who, I know these guys aren't making a lot of money, even with some work study programs, or they're disabled, or in some cases, they're veterans or soldiers who are fighting for us right now overseas. They don't pay an income tax. And so I just think it's very important for us to understand Americans work hard, and if they're not working right now, I promise you they want to get to work, and that's what my economic plan is designed to do, to get more people back to work and to lift up the middle class and people who want to work to get into the middle class.
Hell no, it's not an SOS call. This is a call for that 1% motherfucker. You know him. So you have to take your thumbs in between the cracks of his face and pull it over because it's sitting on his shoulder, and fucking blow some fire on that shit. And on three, people, you know where I'm going with this. On a one, and on a two, and on a three with a big woosah. Asshole of the day. Hey, yes, yo, Bible Belt. What part of religious stupidity do you think you portray when you're aligning yourself with an antichrist and are too blind and racist to see that Mittens is about to fuck you as well as me? You know, the nigga with the motherfucking gun, bitch. That nigga Mitt Romney is now 10 for 10 for the year on the shit list. Check it. In a book called Can Romney serve two masters, the Mormon Church versus the office of the presidency of the United States of America? Author and defector of the pseudo-religion, Trisha Erickson, says Romney believes that Mormonism teaches what we call a pre-existing, called a pre-existence on God, the Father's, on God, the Father's planet, as spirit children before we're planted in our mother's wombs. And the reason why we're here, according to Mormonism, is so that we can work out our own progression to godhood and our own planets themselves. Okay, what the fuck? Okay, so the founder, Joseph Smith, was a philandering wife collector, okay? High on drugs when he founded his cult and was mentally retarded enough in history. So much that even Hollywood helped make the fucking movie about his life a historic in conjecture. Personally, my daft, stupid bitch of a mother had us kids into that web of denial as well, because she couldn't trust the Baptist system of pimping as she had done so with Reverend Ike. You know, that prayer cloth sold in the billions to poor nigga bitches who followed a pimp named Slickback all day. Mormons have more people in the CIA and the FBI. They have an employment office for Mormons in DC to be able to infiltrate them into the government, okay? And then they've been trying since the beginning to get someone in the presidency because they believe they have to establish their authority so when Jesus comes to earth, the Mormon church will take control of the government and the Mormons will be the government of God on earth. It's not what would Jesus do, it's how the fuck do I get out of this country when you got this crack-ass motherfucker about to have us all killed under his fake-ass religious stupidity when church and state are supposed to be separate. Here we condemn Islam because it's the first religion, first world religion that's mostly black-based, and by sheer hypocrisy allow the shaitan to visit countries in a bid for power but have the foreign policy grace of a jackass. Israel, are you listening? Okay, are you listening? Okay, or are you as racist as well when a motherfucker don't limp to your constant whining about taking land from Palestinians, the Falasha, and of Africa as a power move? Perish the thought. Israel is overrated. But with Obama, but with the elections within the next 3 weeks, the America can sellout will ply his racist cries to remove Lord Obama so that hell may reign on earth, or at least continued here forever. Yep, Big Bird Mittens is yet again the stupidest asshole of the day. Let me hear ya say amen.
Warriors, lovers, lend me your ears and discover God's got your back in the spiritual sense. For the first time, I rhyme, I'm the hardest in stress. Punk ass haters make me flex. I'd rather cremate the block when I'm vexed. Yo, fucking asshole, where you go? You're next. I got a bullet with your name, so fucking protect your neck. Please try me. One call, I got a galaxy. Globally connected, I got bombs, G. Point blank like Tybo, weak niggas chalk the floor. Collect my furious metal and blast the church at your funeral and eat the ashes like a bowl of milkless cereal.
Boom, bang! Ride or die. Ride or die. Ride or die. Boom, bang! Ride or die. Ride or die, ride or die. Boom, bang.
Kablam, see that shot, the one to the left. God says you're lucky cause I barely miss. I got your face in the center of the target. And if I see you, then I'll check you out like Walmart or at the bus stop or alley. Anytime I need to feel alive, being deadly. Bushmaster cold hearted, I strike. But if I gotta take a bullet for mine, then I'm right. Beneath the city of shit, I rewrote the stasis. Convert plans to upset your universe from my minivan.
Ah, yes, if you missed it, then play it again till you get it. You can say moving forward like a bitch, but you know I'm ahead of your bullshit. This has been your radio show of shows, Bust That Ass Radio, 83.17 FMX, and the X stands for You Never Seen Me Coming When You Never Saw Where I've Been, all up in your ass. Steady shellac in the room, boom, boom, harder than ever, booty bubbles and dirty condoms. Music provided by Omega 7 Records, the Mothership Connection, a.k.a. Destruct and the Underground Music Scene. Cash your ass, see you in the street, bitches. Rah!
stronger than the chain of assassins. We command respect inside prison, not sagging, cause the enemy's playing in mag suits. This is who we're recognizing. It's all for one, cause if you got bigger balls, you either ride in common sense or die just because. As thrill killers, we don't